Is it December already? Alrighty then, that came fast again this year. Oh well, time flies when you live in the cloud, I guess. This time I have some VPN gateway improvements, some application gateway updates, and more Azure function features. I'm Lars Klint, and this is Azure This Week, a show made entirely from the available space in your storage account. When your company sets up a local network, it is with a local IP range, such as starting at 10.1.1.1 or 192.168.1.1. When two of those networks need to talk over VPN and there is an overlap of IP addresses as defined, you have a problem. You don't want your office printer to suddenly share an IP address with your new Pixel 6 Pro. There's a new service for Azure VPN Gateway that can help though. The Network Address Translation, NAT, N-A-T, feature is designed to solve that scenario. That's when private networks are connected using VPN over the internet or across private WAN. NAT on a gateway device translates the source and or destination IP addresses based on the NAT policies or rules to avoid address conflict. This is another step towards a more robust and versatile hybrid environment. Well done, Azure. If you'd like to learn more about cloud development with or without specific networking elements, check out ACG's free plan. Gives you access to free courses and quizzes, plus learning paths and original series content. And you don't need a credit card to sign up. I'll include a link in the description below. Azure Application Gateway is a layer 7, meaning the HTTP layer, routing service for incoming traffic for a web application. Among other features, you can route traffic based on URL path, such as slash images or slash customer, to multiple backend web applications. It's an elegant way to optimize a single customer facing site within your Azure infrastructure. One of the hurdles has been that you had to fully qualify all paths you wanted to route, which was a bit rigid and at times hard to manage. From this week though, Azure Application Gateway supports the use of wildcard characters such as asterisks, the star, and question mark for host names on a multi-site HTTPS listener. That should make the service so much more configurable for more scenarios. And finally, a small but significant update to app services and Azure Functions. The custom OpenID provider for these two services is now in general availability. If you're wondering what OpenID is, it is an open standard and decentralized authentication protocol. It is a standardized way of authenticating users, such as when you log into that event website to buy tickets for the Greece Revival Tour using your Facebook account. Well, you can now use custom OpenID providers if you happen to have rolled your own. I'm not going to go into how you register your application with a custom OpenID provider, but that is why I've linked to the Azure docs below. Oh, did I mention that it works with Azure Functions too? We are at the end of the news for this week. I did want to mention that the brand new AZ 500 course launched on the ACG platform this week. The incredible Azure security wizard, also known as James Lee, is the master behind that course. Also, check out some of the many other free original series we have on the ACG platform, such as cloud provider comparisons, certification guides, and programming languages of the cloud. There's much learning to be done. As we say on the A Cloud Guru team, when you realize too late that it's December and you haven't got anything to wear, but then remember that the hat budget got approved early. I forgot to bring up the Santa hat. Got approved early? Remember that the had budget got approved early? Seek and you shall cloud. See you next week and keep being awesome, Cloud Guru Santas.